Welcome to the IFS application tutorial video on preparing a research budget. The budget is a key part of a funding proposal. Your budget should describe what you plan to spend your funding on and how it will be used to answer your research question. Prepare your budget early so that you can ensure that your project is appropriate for the amount of funding available. Preparing a budget for your IFS application can be broken down into 5 steps. 1. Plan your activities. 2. Check the guidelines. 3. Reasonably cost each item. 4. Explain and justify each item. And 5. Prepare your IFS application. 1. Planning your activities. Write a list of everything you plan to do. Try to be as specific as possible. Include quantities. For example, how many samples do you plan to collect? How many sites do you plan to visit? And how many days will you spend doing each activity? Go through your list of activities and write down what you need for each. For example, do you need a piece of equipment to fulfill a certain activity? Or consumables for another activity? Will you need to travel or pay for manpower? Again, be as specific and include quantities. Make sure you write everything down that you need. Then note after if it's already available in your institute or university, or if you will need to buy it. Here is an example of what a plan might look like. First off, to start my project, I need to collect 100 samples from 5 sites in July. For this task, I'll need stationery, 2 scissors, and a handheld GPS. These are all already available at my university, so I will not need to buy them. However, I will need to buy 100 plastic bags and a tape measure. Secondly, I'll have to travel to Site 1 on the 12th of July. And to get there, I'll need to buy a train ticket for one person. Next, I'll spend 2 days there to get my samples. Therefore, I'll need to pay for a stay at a hotel for at least one night and buy food for 2 days. When writing this list, keep in mind that you can make your budget go further by considering if any items are already available in your university or institute. Can you borrow certain items from a colleague? This way you can save money and use your funding towards other items that can benefit your research. When you're done with your list, go through your list with a colleague, explaining what you plan to do, and be sure to answer any questions they might have. Two, check the guidelines. The application guidelines for the IFS grants can be found on our online platform, the IFS Community. This can be reached through our website. When you have logged into the IFS Community, click on Guidelines for Application in brackets Content. Then, scroll down almost to the bottom of the page where you will find information on preparing the budget for an IFS application. Carefully read this document. Find out what the rules are and note them down. Find out what can and cannot be bought with IFS funding, and how you should present your budget. Refer back to your list and cross out any items that you plan to buy that are not covered by IFS. For example, IFS grants cannot be used to purchase vehicles. If this is on your list, you should cross it out and either replace it with an item that is covered by IFS, like vehicle rental, or make plans to obtain it through another funding source. Here is a brief overview of the rules for an IFS grant. There are different maximum amounts for different types of grants. You can request a maximum of $15,000 for the basic grant and $12,000 for the renewal grant. This amount covers the complete project period and is not an annual budget. Budget items must of course be related to your project, and you should clearly justify why each item is needed. It is important to remember that including budget items that are not covered by IFS may lead to the rejection of your application. Alternatively, if your application is recommended for support, items that are not covered by IFS will be cut from your budget and you will receive less money overall that could have otherwise been put towards permitted items. To avoid this and to get the most out of your budget, be sure to follow the guidelines carefully. Budget items that are not covered by the IFS basic and renewal grants include institutional overheads, salaries, honoraria, vehicles, dissemination costs like publications, conferences, and workshops, and any unexplained miscellaneous cost. Budget items that are covered include equipment, expendable supplies, consumables, the purchasing of literature, documentation, or information, and where needed, IFS will also cover the cost of freight charges, insurance, and import tax, but these should be presented as part of the cost of the item and not as a budget item in itself. We also cover any costs associated with local travel, but this has to be broken down into actual costs like accommodation, food, tickets, and fuel, fieldwork or manpower costs, and any other necessary costs that are justified. We will look at each of these budget categories in detail towards the end of this tutorial. 3. Reasonably cost each item. You will have to provide an estimated cost for each item which is realistic and reflects the current cost of the item. To do this, you should find out what the price is for each item from different vendors. This will allow you to obtain a realistic and competitive price. Money saved by doing this can be put towards other items that will make your research project go further. You may need to contact the supplier for a quote. Calculate any extra costs associated with the item, such as shipping, taxes, and insurance. When you have found a suitable price, write your estimate in a spreadsheet including all the details mentioned above so that you can refer back to it later. Here is an example of what your spreadsheet might look like. It is good to have this information noted down as you may need to clarify to IFS where you have found some of your cost estimates, and you will definitely need this information when you start your project and begin purchasing items. 4. Explain and justify each item. Explain what the item is, provide detailed information, and explain why you need it for your research project. Do not oversimplify your descriptions or justifications. Include enough details so that another expert in your field of research can see how it relates to your project. Link it to your project by describing what stage or activity or objectives you need the item for. If the item is more expensive than usual, explain why this is. Refer back to your spreadsheet and add the description and justification for each item. You can also group similar low-cost items together. For example, here I have grouped autoclave tape, parafilm, and gloves as microbiology consumables. The description under the column named IFS Budget Justification describes what they will be used for referring to the specific experiment they will be used in, and also list the individual items with their costs, including shipping and taxes. Giving a breakdown of the costs in this way enables the reviewers to see how you will have reached your final figure. By preparing all this information beforehand, you'll be able to simply copy and paste it into the online application form. Now that you know what to do, it's time to prepare your IFS budget. All the information provided here is available in detail in the application guidelines. For equipment, you should list the item separately if it is worth more than $500 or if it has a lifespan of more than 3 years. Describe it in detail, include the manufacturer, model and make, and any accessories that you may need for it. It can be helpful to add the product code, also called catalog number, which can be found on the manufacturer's website for the item, or you can also include a website link if you have one. Justify why you need the specific item and what part of your research plan does it relate to. Make sure you include freight charges, insurance, import taxes when estimating the cost. For expendables, you should divide these into categories. These can be, for example, glassware, feed, reagents, or test kits. In the description, you should provide quantities and the price per item so that we can understand how you reach your total amount. As with equipment, you can also add the product code or website link. And also you should justify why you need it, as usual. Include any freight charges, insurance, and import taxes in your calculations. All requested literature, documents, and information can only total up to $500. Unless you provide a good justification for needing higher amounts. When presenting these items, divide them into categories, for example, books, reprints, or photocopies. For books, provide details on the book and, as usual, justify why you need it for your research. Before requesting journal papers, you may want to email the author of the paper to ask for a copy. Many authors will share their papers for free. Finding these free articles will help you allocate your budget towards items that are not freely available. IFS can support travel for your research, as long as it is local. Divide this into categories, for example, accommodation, food, tickets, fuel. Many applicants request per diems or allowances, but these should be broken down into actual costs. We cannot accept per diems that differ per person, for example, different rates for researcher, assistant, or driver, as we only cover actual costs if the cost is meant to cover the same amount of food, accommodation, or travel for each person. It should be the same for everyone. As with other items, you should justify why you need travel for your research. If sites are far away from your institute or university, explain why they were selected. Explain how you reached your final estimate. Give details such as distance, number of trips, mileage rate, price per ticket, so that we can understand how you calculated your total cost. Costs relating to fieldwork and manpower include manual labor. You should detail this in pay per hour or days. Note that costs can only be covered if labor is outsourced. People, including the applicant, already hired by the administering institute, cannot be paid for labor, as their salary should be covered by the institute. If there are any other costs that do not fit into the five previous categories, you can specify them as other, as long as you describe them clearly, provide a suitable justification, and ensure that the costs are not institutional overheads, salaries, honoraria, vehicles, publication costs, conferences, or other dissemination costs, or an unexplained miscellaneous costs. In general, good budgets are easy to follow, and one can understand how the total cost was calculated for each item. It should include a short but detailed description of what the item is. Including a website link or catalog number can be very helpful as well. It should clearly justify why each item is needed for the project. And lastly, the items should be obviously reasonably costed with any additional costs explained. A tip to improve your budget is to ask a friend to critically evaluate it. They should consider the following questions when doing so. Are your descriptions clear? Can they understand how you reached your total cost? And are they convinced by your justification? If not, you'll need to make some changes. To hone your own skills in preparing budgets, you can also try evaluating someone else's. Try to look at a budget through the eyes of a funder and ask yourself, would you fund this project? And that's it. Just remember those 5 steps we covered. Plan your activities, check the guidelines, cost each item, explain and justify them, and prepare your IFS budget accordingly. Now that you have finished the IFS budget tutorial, we recommend that you do some more background reading. There are many useful articles on how to prepare a budget online. For starters, we recommend these 2 articles, How to Make a Simple Research Budget on the Research Whisperer blog, and How to Budget Your Grant Proposal, which can be found on the Science website. Many of their useful tips were presented here in this tutorial. Also check out part 2 of the IFS application tutorial video, where we will go through some examples of good and bad budgets. Thank you for your interest in the IFS program, and we hope you have found this tutorial helpful and wish you the best of luck with your IFS application.